Yeah, Gavin, you said you like drawings. I thought I'd show you some of my drawing. Not that it's very engineering or anything like that. Just some schematic stuff and drawings that I did to try to do my balcony and stuff. Just stages and steps. And yeah, I'm really well organized. more drawings. That makes any sense to anybody, but what the hell. Yeah, that's all this stuff. All this stuff that I'm working on. No, front elevation, we're putting the door thing in on the dormer. It's the deck that I'm trying to put in with the posts that have to be secured in an acceptable fashion for the municipality's regulations.
My home, added balcony, put in railing, change electrical. I had to because it was too close to the railing for it to be a deck. Making a membrane down there, I gotta put I'm making a kind of a deck to stand on that I can put out there on there. Doing insulating. View from the deck. Got my beautiful dead tree with a bunch of vines growing on it. I like that thing, it's nice. Put the electrical system in. Switched up to 200 amp? Yeah. Vinyl siding. It's nice when it's all done so I can actually focus on other things. And the downstairs. Took some of the stuff out because I had to reinforce some of this stuff up here. Change some of the stuff up there, put insulation in, had to strengthen some beams and add these pieces along the length here in order to strengthen, because the wall upstairs is actually where those beams are, whereas the wall goes up to the exterior wall there. A lot of work to do. Got to insulate, bigger barrier, drywall, made the back dormer to soften the fascia. Out of there. And like all the trees in my backyard. So nice. My shed. I don't do videos out in the shed, Kevin. I had to change the roof on this place, and I put the sliding door in up there and put the deck in. I had to put the railings up. A lot more work to do in the place. I had to put the softened fascia in. Still not finished the soften fascia. I gotta get the sides done up here, otherwise the squirrels just chew right into it and end up getting into the house. Look at that little guy. He's relaxing right now. Oh, those white spots. Somebody threw bleach at you? No, he's not dead, he's just relaxing. The rim of the deck have the rail of the stairs. A little leftover badass here, this insulation I'm doing here. See, you got the insulation going up there. Underneath that, there is something I've installed. See these things here? It's a kind of a styrofoam, I guess it is. But these things break apart along the seam there, you can see, like that. And this will go up against, see, it's got a channel in it there, and you can see, yeah, see the channel that goes along there, this is going to go up against the ceiling, like so. It's going to go up against the that insulation there, on the other side of that insulation is one of these, and that's up against the roof, the panel that's the roof, and the roof panel gets shined on by the sun and it gets heated up, which heats up the air underneath it, collects underneath that panel, and heat rises, so it'll go up into the attic, and it's going to suck air because there is a fascia underneath there with a vent that allows cool air to come back in under that. And the reason that I do that, that I'm going to be doing that, I got to replace some under here. You can see, I don't know if you can see that, there's a opening there, and the squirrels have taken away this stuff. It goes over to here. You can see some that's gotten chewed up in there. I don't know if that's going to show up or not, if it's bright enough. But I've got to pull that out and put a new one in and put insulation over it the way that is there. And what that'll do is it'll allow the roof to cool. The shingles, if you don't have that ventilation, the heat builds up in there and the shingles, they just deteriorate a lot faster if you don't do that sort of thing. So that's one of the things I'm doing, plus putting all this, there was no insulation, it was all like that over there. You can see that board there. And that was just wall, and there was drywall over it. Now I'm putting insulation. I'll put vapor barrier over that to keep moisture from building up and allowing mold to grow in there. And that will help to reduce costs and heating and cooling. Some badass, huh? Thought I'd try and explain this roof thing, what I'm doing with the insulation, a little bit better. If you look at this drawing, it's a kind of a cross-section of the roof. And you have a summertime problem, you have a wintertime problem. I already described the summertime problem. The wintertime problem is this. You have the sun shining down on, but it's cold outside, and you have snow built up on the exterior. Now, the heat, without the insulation, inside the house is going to melt the snow from this bottom here. On the roof line, and it's going to go down, it's going to trickle down until it goes past the exterior wall line. You see the exterior wall is right here, and what happens is the water will go down here until it reaches a point past the interior wall, and it'll form ice damming over here. This will turn into a block of ice, and it'll build up and build up and build up until it actually gets underneath the shingles and into the house. It's one of the problems I had with damage, was water damage due to ice damming. So what I'm going to do is insulate so that the insulation here is going to keep the heat on the interior from getting to the exterior wall. Now, the sun is going to be shining down, but if you have a layer of snow over here, it's not going to actually do anything. It's not going to melt if you don't have any heat going to it. But also, another thing to do is down here you have a vent in the soffit, and it allows cool air to come in here, so if the sun does happen to get down on the roof, then it's going to heat up in there, and it's going to rise, causing a vacuum in here, and suck up cool air in here, draw it up, and keep the snow on the roof frozen, so that it doesn't melt and form an ice dam. And as I said, in the summertime, you have the sun shining down on the roof and building up heat in here. And again, heat rises, so you have that vent over there and allows the roof to stay cooler because it's going to draw cool air and it's going to rise up to the top into the attic, which is ventilated, and it'll go outside. So what you end up with is the interior of the house will stay cooler because the heat isn't building up in there and coming into the interior. Well, hopefully that makes a little bit of sense. Okay, badass!